Hello, boys and girls. Welcome to the Ministry of Education and Partners COVID-19 Teaching by Radio program. The Ministry of Education and Partners COVID-19 Teaching by Radio program is a 30-minute radio intervention support program that is meant to provide continuous instruction to keep you academically engaged during this stay-at-home period, as well as preparing you, our 6th, 9th, and 12th graders for the pending Liberia Primary School Certificate Exam, Liberia Junior High School Certificate Exam, and West Africa Senior Secondary Certificate Exam when the time comes. Also, in addition to this academic support, the program is meant to provide psychosocial support for learners, teachers, and parents, and also tips on how you as parents and teachers can provide support to your students and children at home. Now, let's join our teacher for today's lesson.
Hello, students. We are teachers Che Kribo T.K. Solomon
and Mr. Aaron T. Bala
of Rising Academies. Today is the Rising Youth Movement Partnership for the Ministry of Education COVID-19 Teaching by Radio program. Lesson number 15. Our lesson today is Language Arts for the students of grade 3 and 4, and the topic is Liberia's Mineral Resources. While we listen to these COVID-19 health tips, please take out your pencil, pen, and copy books and get ready for today's lesson. Again, welcome and let's learn.
What are the symptoms of COVID-19? COVID-19 symptoms include cough, fever, shortness of breath. In rare cases, COVID-19 can lead to severe respiratory problems, kidney failure, or death. If you have a fever or any kind of respiratory difficulty, such as coughing and shortness of breath, call your doctor.
Now it's time for our lesson. Today, we have another reading session together. I'm feeling great because I know we will do a lot of fun activities. How are you feeling today? We have 6 fun activities to do today. Number 1, sentence warm up. Number 2, sight words. Number 3, brilliant blending. Number 4, write and read. Number 5, listen and write. Number 6, read aloud. Let's have a great class together. First, it is time for our sentence warm up. Today, our practice sentence is Liberia has gold and diamonds. You will listen while I say the sentence 2 times. Then, I will tell you when it is time for us to read the sentence together. Ready? Listen first. Liberia has gold and diamond. Liberia has gold and diamond. Okay, when I say your turn, then we can all say it together. Ready? Your turn.
Liberia has gold and diamond.
One more time.
Liberia has gold and diamond.
Great. When I hear the sentence, Liberia has gold and diamond, I think about a man operating a big yellow machine, scooping dirt off the ground in search for gold and diamond. I also think about a group of people digging a big hole into the earth with their shovels and diggers, extracting gold and diamond. Gold and diamond are minerals that look like rocks, but are usually made of just one kind of non-living substance or material. People want to collect gold and diamond to easily hammer them into different shapes like rings, chains, bands, and other important materials. I want you to think about how you would do a drama for the sentence Liberia has gold and diamond. Will you pretend to be a machine digging a big hole in the side of a mountain? Will you pretend to be a gold or a diamond that is used to make rings? Will you be a mountain that is getting smaller as people take the gold and diamond away? I will give you 5 seconds to think about how you will do a drama to show the sentence, Liberia has gold and diamond. I hope you have your drama idea ready. Now, I will say the sentence and you will do your drama. Ready? Your turn. Liberia has gold and diamond. Wow! The students here with me did a wonderful drama. I wish I could see your beautiful drama at home too. I am sure you did a great job. Now, I have some questions for you. When I ask the question, if the answer is yes, stand up. If the answer is no, sit down. Number one, do people get diamonds from the mountains? Number two, do people get gold from the trees? Number three, do people get gold from the hills? The last question, do people get diamond from plastic bags? Wonderful job answering those questions. Now, let's say the word diamond. I wonder if you can tell me how many syllables in the word diamond. You will listen while I clap the syllables in the word. Then, I will tell you when it is time for you to try. Ready? Listen first. Diamond. Diamond. Your turn. Diamond. Diamond. Great job. How many syllables in the word diamond? Yes, there are two syllables. Diamond is one word with two syllables. Is diamond a noun, a verb, or an adjective? Remember, a noun is a word that names person, place, thing, or idea. Diamond is a noun. Diamond is like a rock that is made of just one kind of non-living material or substance. The word diamond is singular, while the word diamonds is plural. Thank you very much. Now it's time for sight words. This is the new part of our lesson where we will review sight words. Sight words are words that we use a lot, so we want to be able to read them quickly when we see them. In your notebook, I want you to have a special place where you write your sight words. Every day you will put your sight words in the same place. It could be at the front of your book or it could be at the back of your book. But you need 4 pages only for sight words. On sight words page 1, you will write the number 9 and 10 with a space next to each number for a word. Go ahead and write number 9 and 10. Now, you will write the sight word I tell you next to the numbers. Number 9. Write the word is. This word has 2 letters, and it is spelled I-S. Number 10, write the word U. This word has 3 letters, and it is spelled Y-O-U. Let's also review numbers from before. Last time, we had 2 other sight words. They were, number 7 is the word in. This word has 2 letters and it is spelled I-N. Number 8 is the word on. This word has 2 letters and it is spelled O-N. Fantastic! Now we will play a sight words game. I will say a word and you will point to the word in your notebook and we will say how to read it. It could be sight words that you wrote before. Ready? Is. Point to the word is in your notebook. Look at the word and read it. Is. You. Point to the word you in your notebook. Look at the word and read it. you. In. Point to the word in your notebook. Look at the word and read it. In. On. Point to the word on in your notebook. Look at the word and read it. On. Is. Point to the word is in your notebook. Look at the word and read it. Is. Or. Point to the word or in your notebook. Look at the word and read it. Odd. You. Point to the word you in your notebook. Look at the word and read it. You. Two. Point to the word two in your notebook. Look at the word and read it. Two. Great job with our sight words today. Remember, save those 4 pages in your notebook for your collection of sight words. We will add more sight words in our next session. Thank you for this activity. We'll move to teacher Aaron Bala for our brilliant blending.
Okay, students, before we go to our next activity, let's hear a short message.
What are the symptoms of COVID-19? COVID-19 symptoms include cough, fever, shortness of breath. In rare cases, COVID-19 can lead to severe respiratory problems, kidney failure, or death. If you have a fever or any kind of respiratory difficulty, such as coughing and shortness of breath, call your doctor.
Students, this is time for our next activity called Brilliant Blending. Are you ready? At the beginning of a word, sometimes we have one sound and sometimes we have two sounds. Today, we will practice some words that have two or three sounds at the beginning. Listen. Got. G-A-T. Got. The letter G makes the sound G. O makes the sound A. And T makes the sound T. Now you can try this with me. Get ready. Your turn.
Got.
G.
A.
T.
Got.
Again.
G. A. T. Got.
Great job. Our next word is strand. Listen. Stir. And. Strand. The letters S, T, and R make the sounds stir. A makes the sound A. And N and D together make the sounds nd. Now you can try this with me. Get ready. Your turn.
Strand.
Stir.
A.
Nd.
Strand.
Again.
Stir.
A.
Nd.
Strand.
Great job. Our next word is wig. Listen. W-A-G. Wig. The letter W makes the sound W. I makes the sound A. And G makes the sound G. Now you can try this with me. Get ready. Your turn.
Wig.
W-A-G.
Wig.
Again.
W-A-G.
Wig.
Great job. Our next word is long. Listen. Long. The letter L makes the sound L. O makes the sound A. N and G together make the sound M. Now you can try this with me. Get ready. Your turn.
Long. Long.
Again.
Long.
Great job. Our next word is blonde. Listen. B-L-O-N-D, blonde. The letters B and L together make the sounds bl. O makes the sound a, and N and D make the sounds nd. Now you can try this with me. Get ready. Your turn.
Blonde. Bl. A. Nd. Blonde.
Again.
Bl. A. Nd. Blonde.
Great job. Our last word is mat. Listen. M-A-T, mat. The letter M makes the sound A makes the sound A, and T makes the sound T. Now you can try this with me. Get ready. Your turn.
Mat. M-A-T, mat.
Again.
M-A-T, mat.
Excellent work. Now it is time for our next activity called Write and Read. I'm going to spell a word for you to write. Then we will read the word together. Number one, write the word spelled G-O-T. Now try to read and pronounce this word on your own. Great job. Listen when I sound out the word. G-O-T, got. The letter G makes the sound G. O makes the sound A. And T makes the sound T. Now you can try this with me. Your turn.
G-O-T, got.
Again.
G-O-T, got.
Great job. Number two. Write the word spelled W-I-G. Now try to read and pronounce this word on your own. Great job. Listen when I sound out the word. W-I-G, wig. The letter W makes the sound W-I makes the sound A, and G makes the sound G. Your turn.
W-I-G, wig.
Again.
W-I-G, wig.
Great job. Number three. Write the word spelled B-L-O-N-D. Now try to read and pronounce this word on your own. Great job. Listen when I sound out the word. B-L-O-N-D, blonde. The letters B and L together make the sounds B-L. O makes the sound A. And N and D together make the sounds N-D. Your turn.
B-L-O-N-D,
blonde. Again.
B-L-O-N-D, blonde.
Great job. Students, our next activity is listen and write. Are you ready? Great. I want you to listen carefully. Number one, write the sentence, I got a long blonde strand from a wig on the mat. I will read the sentence again for the last time. I got a long blonde strand from a wig on the mat. Good job. Now we are going to check and see if you wrote your words correctly. Ready? Number one. I is a sight word and it is spelled I. Number two. Got. Got has the sounds G, G-O-T. And it is spelled G-O-T. A is a sight word, and it is spelled A. Number four, long. Long has the sounds L, A, N, and it is spelled L, O, N, G. Number five, blonde. Blonde has the sounds bl, a, nd, and it is spelled b, l, o, n, d. Number six, strand. Strand has the sounds str, a, nd, and it is spelled s, t, r, a, n, d. Number seven, from. From has the sounds fr, a, m, and it is spelled f, r, o, m. Number eight, wig. Wig has the sounds w, e, g, and it is spelled w, I, g. Number nine, mat. Mat has the sounds m, a, t, and it is spelled m, a, t. Now, I want you to look at the words and read them as I say the sentence again. I got a long blonde strand from a wig on the mat. I got a long blonde strand from a wig on the mat. Remember, this is a statement. So the first letter of the first word should be capitalized, and there should be a period mark at the end. What does the sentence, I got a long blonde strand from a wig on the mat, means? The word strand means a long piece. So I had a blonde wig, and a piece of a wig came off onto the mat. I need to clean my mat so that there are no hairs from a blonde wig on the floor. Excuse me, why I sweep my room in my blonde wig? Let's read the sentence together, students.
I got a long blonde strand from a wig on the mat.
Again.
I got a long blonde strand from a wig on the mat.
Great job. Wow. Students, it is time for our last activity. Let's join Teacher Kubo for our read aloud.
Thank you, Teacher Aaron. I'm going to read you another passage about Liberia's mineral resources. This test comes from the Accelerated Quality Education Level 2 Teacher Guides in the Learner Webbook series by USAID and the Ministry of Education. This passage is called Part 2, Liberia's Mineral Resources. Hearing this title makes me ask questions like, why Liberia needs mineral resources? What are some of the important minerals Liberia has? Why if Liberia never had mineral resources? What could have happened to her? Part 2. Liberia's mineral resources. Iron ore. After the war, we did not export iron ore. This is one of the reasons why Liberia has had less money to invest in building the country. In the past, money from exporting iron ore was used to help build schools, enroll and pay government workers. Gold and diamond mining. Liberia still has some gold and diamonds in the sand at the bottom of some streams. During the war, there was much fighting over the diamond and gold mines. Now, there are fewer jobs mining gold and diamonds. Other important minerals: tin, bauxite, manganese, limestone, and sand. Liberia has many other minerals. For example, bauxite is mined and used to make aluminum. Tin is mined for use in buildings and to make tin cans. Manganese is mined to use in fertilizer. As more rebuilding goes on in Liberia, the need for limestone and sand to make cement is growing. This is a growing small business for many Liberians. Wow, what an interesting reading. Based on what we learned, maybe we can answer some of the questions we had at the beginning. Number one, why Liberia needs mineral resources?
In the passage, I remember reading the sentence, "In the past, money from exporting iron ore was used to help build schools and roads and pay government workers. Therefore, Liberia needs mineral resources to help build schools, hospitals, good roads, bridges, to do other good things for the country. She also needs mineral resources to pay government workers."
Great. So, what are some of the important minerals Liberia has?
Let me think. In the passage, I remember reading the sentences, Liberia has many other minerals. For example, bauxite is mined and used to make aluminum. Tin is mined for use in building and to make tin cans. Manganese is mined to use in fertilizer. As more building goes on in Liberia, the need for limestones and sand to make cement is growing. So, some of the important minerals Liberia has are tin, bauxite, manganese, limestone, and sand.
Wow. My last question. Why, if Liberia never had mineral resources, what would have happened to her?
Okay. In the passage, I remember reading the sentences, after the war, we did not export iron ore. This is one of the reasons why Liberia has had less money to invest in building the country. So, if Liberia never had mineral resources, there will be less money to invest in building the country or to even pay government workers.
Wow, what an informative passage. We learned a lot of Liberia's mineral resources. The iron ore, gold, diamonds, tin, bauxite, manganese, limestone, and sand. Thank you for listening. We have another interesting story for you in our next lesson. Let's stay safe and keep learning together. Thank you very much. We move to Teacher Aaron for our summary of our lesson.
Great job. Students, this is time for us to recap what we have learned today. We practiced the sentence, Liberia has gold and diamond. We practiced blending sounds to read and write words like got, strand, wig, long, blonde, and matte. We learn and play a game with some words. Is, you, in, and on. Lastly, we read and discussed the passage part 2, Liberia's mineral resources. Thank you very much. Boys and girls, if you have any questions on today's lesson, you can kindly send them through this number, 0555670833. Again, if you have any questions on today's lesson, you can kindly send them through this number 0555 670833. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you for that helpful reminder. Boys and girls, that is the end of our class today. We are so happy you were here with us. We hope to talk to you again soon. Goodbye from me, J. Kribo T.K. Solomon.
And goodbye from me, Mr. Aaron T. Bala.